Well, with a winter storm warning in effect, there's a lot of snow emergency declarations and school closures. And the big question now that we have for you, do you think schools should close for this week's extreme cold? A lot of districts having to weigh that. Go to care11.com/vote now. Sharon Hughes is covering that angle. She is live in the South Metro this morning. Good morning, Sharon.
Good morning, Lauren. We're live out here in Chanhassen, and you can see, I don't know if you can really see, but the snow is still coming down. Not too many cars on the roads right now, but definitely people are out shoveling. The plows are out here as well. We are keeping an eye on school closures and delays. Take a look at this list that we pulled from our website here. Right now, it's looking like over 260 schools are closed this morning, and at least 170 others are running on a delayed schedule for today. Some major school districts closed this hour include Moundsview, Burnsville, Egan Savage, and Stillwater. And as of right now, it seems like schools like Minnetonka and Orono Public Schools are running on a 2-hour delay. Also, at this point, it looks like the city of Richfield and city of Lonsdale have declared snow emergencies. You may have to keep an eye on your city's website in case your city decides to do the same, because that will affect street parking for people who do park outside. And of course, as Sven said, with the extreme cold coming in tonight and also tomorrow, no word yet on whether Minneapolis and St. Paul will extend their school closure beyond today. But of course, we'll be keeping an eye out for that announcement, and we'll bring it to you right here as soon as we get it. Guys.
All right, Sharon, thanks for keeping us posted. Right now, most of our viewers, 92% of them, saying schools should be closed for the extreme cold this week. Now let's check in with Kaya Edwards. She is braving the cold and snow in southern Minnesota. So Kaya, where are you at and how are things looking there?
Hey, good morning. So we are in the Inver Grove Heights area right now. We started in Golden Valley where Kara is, and we're making our way south to Rochester because look, there's a lot of snow. It's not stopping people though from getting on the roads. We're seeing traffic moving along just fine in both directions so far, though people are of course taking it slower, which has been the message all morning. Drive carefully, drive slowly. So if you take a look at the roads, you can see that there's even this one right here closest to us. It is covered in snow. And then if you look at where there are more cars driving right now, you'll see that there's basically like one center lane that's not as covered. But hopefully you prepared for all of this. We want to show you this video from just yesterday where Jerry's Foods in Edina, yeah, they saw a lot of people stocking up. And if you were out shopping, you probably saw it too at other stores too. We're hearing about Target, a lot of people out, and also out at the gas stations trying to fill up as well. Now, we want to show you this back out here live because we're doing a little science experiment this morning. Well, I don't know how scientific it is, but we placed my makeup mirror down in the snow just to show you how quickly the snow is coming down, because we thought of this idea. We noticed our car here, our news car, was piling up just in between live shots, or the windshield was, you know, so we're having to just keep cleaning up after this snow. So we wanted to see how much snow could accumulate in half an hour, and that is when we will check in with you next, guys.
All right, Kaya, thank you. Good science experiment there. It's a good way to measure. I appreciate it. Stay safe out there. Ellery?
All right, Lauren, 6:06, it is time for a digital dive. You know, if you haven't made a winter survival kit, now is the time to. No more procrastinating, especially with the snow that's falling and that dangerous cold that's on the way. Well, you can buy a survival kit, but it's easy just to put together one from what you have at home. I do that every single year. And the Minnesota Department of Public Safety, they have a great list of things that you can easily put together in that kit, like have candles and matches, a knife, a red bandana or cloth, something like this color that's really going to get people's attention if you need it, pencil and paper, a whistle, snacks are key, and cell phone chargers, probably a couple of those as well. Flashlights are good to have, and spare batteries. And a good tip with those, flip the batteries around so that you don't accidentally burn them out before you need them. And pro tip, do not keep your emergency kit in your trunk, because when it becomes this cold outside, like it's going to this week, your trunk could freeze shut. So what good is that going to do you? So.
Well, great point. The red bandana or flag. I had no idea. Mm-hmm. I never thought about that, but that is a great tip. And conditions are bad. You want law enforcement to be able to spot you.
Exactly. I have one of those giant triangles that reflects off the road so you can stick it on the back of your car. That's good, too.
Oh, look how prepared you are. All right, Ellery. Thanks. Good tips. Well, a lot of us might think we are saving our backs by ditching the shovel and firing up a snowblower, but there are some risks that come with this time saver. Cleveland Clinic doctors report snowblowers cause more than 5,000 serious injuries every year. Dr. David Shapiro says some people don't realize that turning off the motor on your snowblower to unclog snow doesn't mean it's safe to put your hand inside.
Either there'll be some stored energy in the impeller.
All right, looks like we're having just a little bit of that, but he says the fingers are the most vulnerable spot. Now, the Cleveland Clinic says most snowblower injuries happen to the hands. They can range from cuts to full-blown amputations. Heavy, wet snow, actually more likely to cause an injury because it often creates that blockage in the machine. And you can stay ahead of the winter weather by downloading the Care 11 mobile app. There you'll have live radar, traffic, and school closings 24/7. Now let's take a look at some of the other big local headlines in your morning rush. Time now for the morning rush. A trial is set to begin this morning for Harvey Kniefel. The former Washington County school bus aide is charged with multiple counts of criminal sexual conduct for indecently touching children in 2017. Kniefel could spend 25 years in prison if convicted. At the state capitol, Senator Melissa Franzen and Representative Mike Freiberg plan to introduce a bill outlining the legalization of recreational marijuana for Minnesota. Just last week, a lawmaker proposed putting a measure to legalize pot on the state ballot in 2020. A horrific accident leads to the best possible outcome thanks to multiple Good Samaritans. David Johnson and Maria Berg say they were going home from Maple Grove when they witnessed the crash. The driver of one of the vehicles was pinned inside.
I'm just like, tell me where can you feel your legs? Can you feel your hands? You know, keep looking at my face. I'm like, do not turn your head. I'm trying to hold his head in the car because his seat was all messed up.
Berg, who used to be a police officer for 20 years, says her training kicked in, and that's how she kept the victim awake until help came. Johnson and Berg say they visited the driver yesterday. Anthony Cassif has a broken hip, but is otherwise doing okay.